We already completed our chapter in history. Now we are taking chapter number 13 from geography, the earth in the solar system. First of all, we go with the introduction part. Now we know that total 8 planets there in the solar system. Earth is the third planet from the sun. Now earth, two motions we can say, that is rotation and revolution, are the two motions. Motions means movement of the earth. Now from this diagram we can understand rotation, that means earth rotates on its axis, that is called rotation, and from that rotation we get day and night. Revolution, the earth revolves around the sun and it causes different season. Okay, now we can study with the same help of this globe. As you know, globe is a model of the earth, and first of all we go with the rotation part. As I told you, rotation means rotating on its axis, so this is called rotation, and this is the axis in which globe rotate. And this axis is imaginary, we can't see this axis. Here you can see a middle line, that is called equator, which make two part of this globe. The first part we can see, this is the top, we can see it's a north pole, and the below, that is the south pole. Part from north pole to this equator, that is called northern hemisphere, and the part from this equator to southern pole, that is your southern hemisphere. And if we talk about revolution, see here, I have taken this duster, you can consider this as a sun, and see here this is a chalk. So this we understand as the rotation. Now I will give you what is revolution. Revolution means it is circling around the dust, you can see the duster, it is circling around the sun. So this is called revolution, and both the motions are going simultaneously, that means it is rotating also and revolving also. Thank you.
We already understand the introduction part. Now we move with the lesson. First here we talk about the universe. Now here the universe is boundless. Now what is boundless? Boundless means unlimited. Okay, boundless means unlimited, that means it includes all matter like stars, planets, satellites, etc. So most of our scientists accepted the theory of birth of universe, that is called Big Bang theory. Okay, that means how the birth of universe taken place, we can understand with the help of understanding this Big Bang theory. So what the sources revealed? The sources revealed that the matters like gases, dust particles, all other elements contain a huge big burning ball of fire exploded. Okay, it is exploded. Exploded means blast also we can say. And with that blast, here lots of elements, whatever in that which is thrown out of with a great force in the all of the directions in, and that directions all the matters later on formed stars, and with the passage of time a group of stars formed which we call as a galaxy. So our galaxy is also known as Milky Way. Okay, in Hindi it is known as Akash Ganga. Here our universe born about 13.7 billion years ago, okay, in a massive explosion that we already understood. Now you can see here some link I have given like a chart that shows the relationship, that means here I given In this you can see the earth is a part of solar system. Okay, we understand what is solar system. A solar system includes the sun and its 8 planets. Okay, and the solar system is the part of galaxy, and the galaxy where we live or we belong to is known as Milky Way. But there are millions of galaxies in the universe. Now all these galaxies are related to universe. Okay, so in this way we can see how these all are linked, or we can say related to universe. Now we will discuss about galaxy. We already understand that galaxy is a part of universe, okay, and we belongs to the galaxy called Milky Way, also known as Akashganga. Here galaxy means what? Galaxy means a system, or we can say a group of million or billion of stars together with dust and gas held by gravity. Gravity means gravitational force. So here our galaxy is Milky Way. Now our nearest galaxy to our Milky Way is Andromeda. Okay, the nearest galaxy to our galaxy is Andromeda, and it is, we can say, 2 million light years away from our galaxy. 2 million light year away. Light year. Now what is that light year? Light year is a measurement, or we can say measurement of distance in the space. Okay, a light year means a light which is a light's distance which is traveled in a year. Okay, a light year is what? A distance of light traveled in 1 year is called a light year. That means Andromeda is 2 million light year away from our galaxy. Now here we generally use distance measured in kilometers. Okay, now but in space we can't measure that is in kilometer, so that is why in space the distance is measured in light years. Here the next topic we will understand, that is celestial bodies. Celestial bodies or celestial objects is also known as heavenly bodies or astronomical objects. Now what is celestial body? Celestial objects are those objects that we see in the sky. Okay, and the celestial objects are of two types: emit light, not emit light. Emit means producing light, not producing light. Under emit light we can see star and sun. That means we already know that star and sun, they produce their own light. But not emit light, that means not producing light. Under this we can see planets, moon, comets, asteroids. They are not producing light, they just reflect the light. Okay, so what are celestial objects? Those objects which we see in the sky. Now the next topic is stars. Now any heavenly body that shines by producing its own light is called a star. Okay, that means star we can consider as a giant balls of hot gases that can produce their own light and heat. And we also know that the sun is the center of the solar system which holds all the 8 planets. Okay, and here Alpha and Proxima Centauri, they were the two stars which is very near to our solar system. It's about 4.3 light years away from the sun. Now we already understand what is light year. The distance traveled by light in a year is called light year. Okay, now here it is also mentioned the speed of the light is 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the earth, okay, from the sun. The sun rays which reaches to the earth, that is in 8 minutes and 20 seconds. So here this Alpha and Proxima stars were the only those who are very near to our solar system, or we can say from our sun, that is of 4.3 light years away. That we already understand, stars are heavenly body that shines because they are producing their own light and heat. Okay, so as we know, the stars are uncountable, means we cannot count them. When they form as stars, later on they form a group. Okay, that group means a group of stars forming a recognizable pattern is known as constellation. Okay, so these constellations are recognized easily. So some of are, for example, the Great Bear is also known as Ursa Major, the Little Bear known as Ursa Minor, the Orion, the Hunter, and Scorpio. So these are the some constellation which can easily we can find out in the sky. I have given the picture of all, we can see or we can take a look on that. This constellation is known as the Great Bear, okay, and also known as Ursa Major. Next, this is Hunter, that is Orion the Hunter constellation. Next, Scorpio the Scorpion, and last one is the Little Bear, that means Ursa Minor. So from this pictures we easily understand the different constellation which are recognized in the sky easily. Here the next topic is the solar system. We will go with the word sol. Sol means sun and system means its family. The solar system is the name given to the sun and its 8 planets. Okay, we already understand the heavenly bodies. The planets are the heavenly bodies that revolve around, that includes 8 planets, their satellites, meteors, comets, asteroid. Okay, now we will discuss in solar system about the sun. You can see here I have mentioned some points. Now you know that sun is the center of the solar system. Okay, and its gravity, that means its pulling force which binds means hold the 8 planets in their orbit. Understand? That means it is the sun who holds the 8 planets on their orbit. Now it's a huge ball of hot gases. Okay, understand, full of helium and hydrogen. And here its surface temperature is mentioned as 6000 degrees Celsius. Surface temperature, we can say the outer temperature also. Okay, outer temperature. And the inner temperature, or we can say core temperature, is 15 million or more than that. 15 millions, okay, or more than that. And our Earth is situated 150 million kilometers away from the sun. Understand? 150 million kilometer. That is why we do not feel the extreme heat of the sun. Now here I want to discuss one point. We previously studied that distance of space is measured in the light year. Okay, and here now I spoke about the kilometer. Now what is that? Here I give you some clarity about that. One light year is equal to more than the trillions of kilometer. Okay, it is more than the trillions of kilometer. So when we are measuring the kilometers below the trillions, then we can use the word as kilometer. But if we measuring above the trillions, then we have to definitely use the word as a light year. Understand?